Hey guys, I was just making some dal and for some reason it made me think of Hitler. Maybe because he was a vegetarian. Apparently so. Anyway, so I thought I'd talk to you about Hitler's foreign policy into the Sudetenland.
Da muss der deutsche Junge der Zukunft schlank und rank sein. Flink wie Witthunde, zäh wie Leder und hart wie Krupstahl.
Okay, so one of Hitler's main foreign policy aims was Lebensraum, which means living space. Basically, Hitler wanted to have more space for Germans to live, space that had been taken away by the Treaty of Versailles. And that included the Sudetenland, which was now in Czechoslovakia. Okay, so this is Germany, my dad. And imagine that these, where I pushed all these carrots out, is Czechoslovakia. So Czechoslovakia pushes out into Germany. So Germany surrounds Czechoslovakia, basically, and it comes out a little bit further down there. So Hitler's already taken Austria, the Anschluss of Austria, and has now designs for the Sudetenland, i.e. part of Czechoslovakia. So he basically lets everyone know that this is his intention, this is what he wants to do. And there's obviously a big crisis. Now, this basically ends with Mussolini setting up a meeting in Munich, and Neville Chamberlain from Britain comes along, obviously, and the Munich Agreement is signed, where Hitler promises not to invade the whole of Czechoslovakia, but the Allies or Britain and the rest basically give up the Sudetenland and hand it over to Hitler, hoping now that he is appeased and will not go any further in his aggressive foreign policy for Lebensraum. Okay, so the Munich Agreement basically splits opinion as to whether it's the right move or not. Neville Chamberlain returns back to Britain at the time as a hero. People think that it's great, they've appeased Hitler, they're gonna avoid a war. But people knew that Hitler wasn't going to stop there, and it really was just a delaying tactic to prepare everyone else for war. You know, historians tend to sort of agree now that Chamberlain didn't really have much of an option, and appeasement was the best policy. Britain wasn't ready for war, businesses weren't ready for war, and equally, people believed by that time that the Treaty of Versailles had been a little harsh, and that Hitler Germany was maybe deserving of some of the territory back that it had lost. So overall, you know, appeasement was probably the best solution that Chamberlain could have come up with. But war continued. No. So it didn't stop anything in the end. Okay, so I hope you're all keeping busy. Consider some of the exam questions that you might come across in regards to appeasement, to the Munich Agreement, to the Sudetenland. Think about describing the Munich Agreement, or explain why they appeased Hitler, or how far was appeasement the right solution. So consider the sort of questions that might be asked on this unit. Hope you're all doing well, staying safe, and are still corona-free. Hope I am too, but I guess you don't know. Okay, see you later.